Vietnam, the Fighting Fiats, the Pugnacious Puntos. These little tin-top racers have had many nicknames over the years, but make no mistake, these are serious racing machines. For 2003, the organisers have added an uprated gearbox to the already impressive specification of the Abarth version of the Punto. And with all things being equal, let the best man or woman win. Fiat Punto Abarth Cup burst on the Irish racing scene last year with a six-race series won by former karting champion Richie Faulkner. No less than 26 of these screamers have been snapped up by some of the best pilots in Ireland. Championship leader coming to Mondello is motorsport stalwart Liam Denning. We took a visit to see Liam and family.
To say that the Denning family are into motor cars is a serious underestimation. I mean, just look at all this lot. Cars and definitely into Fiat. My driver Liam got this little Topolino as a present from his dad as his very first car, and in return he has purchased this little 500 for the next Denning generation.
But the next generation will have to wait, as on Sunday mum and dad are going Punto racing.
I suppose you could say, Alison, being in the Denning family, couldn't really have avoided motor racing, could you?
Absolutely not. If you can't beat them, you've got to join them.
And your father, Noel, very keen, very supportive?
Absolutely, yeah. He's delighted at my progress so far, anyway.
What's the most terrifying bit of it all? Is it being on the same grid as your husband, or being surrounded by, what, 24 other men?
Nothing really fazes me. I just get out there and do the best I can.
I'm out there this year trying to do as best I can. I help her on qualifying days, but in the race, we just do our own thing. I think the new class is fantastic. Fiat have supported it greatly. Oisin is doing a great job as our PR guy and running the championship. And I also think all the cars are so evenly matched that no one driver is going to win any more than two races throughout the season.
Well, qualifying hasn't gone that well for Liam this afternoon, who languishes in 10th place behind pole sitter Quentin Smith, while Alison is just two rows behind in 14th. Meanwhile, up front, Joey Freeburn from Armagh will line up third in his self-run machine. Ahead of him, Karl Leonard is continuing the form that took him to victory in round two, while pole sitter Quentin Smith has made it 3 out of 3 in qualifying this year.
And there it is, Quentin Smith, as Declan said, on pole again, the king of qualifying in Fiat Punto Abarth this year, unbeaten to that pole position in three races. On board now with Mark Turley down the back, drafted into Griffin Motorsport to try and sort out his brother's car. We're on board with him this afternoon. And here's Liam Denning, championship leader and winner in this class. A very bad qualifying back down in 10th. But watch this on the front row, a real needle match between these two guys. 5 second board is up, a bit of wheel spin from Smith, and Leonard doesn't need to be asked twice. Right behind him, teammate Gordon Kellett. Looks like Leonard's going to get it. Indeed he does, before the grandstand pulls to the inside, and teammate Kellett behind.
What disastrous start for Quentin Smith. He's back in third place. This is his big chance to get ahead of championship rival Liam Denning. But he's back in third, and that's Alison Lawford. A little bit ahead, and she's getting a nudge.
Mark Turley there on board. Two cars off already. That's Conway and Fitzgerald out onto the grass. Loads of wheels, but no damage. They'll rejoin.
Well, up front, and well, look at that. That's the D-Tech car. Brian Hady hangs adrift, left, drift, right, and he manages to hold on. Tremendous front-wheel drive. Car control from Brian Hade.
On board again with Mark Turley, and it's three abreast. It's Alison on the outside, Kieran Sands and Billy Griffin side by side. Watch out for Turley, he's not going to stay here too long. And there he goes, down the inside in the Ratdown Motors car. Dispatches Billy Griffin and on the tail of Kieran Sands already.
Beautiful opportunistic move there from Mark Turley. He knows about racecraft. Bill Griffin, no easy run. But up front, it looks as if the leading three, that's Carl Leonard, ahead of Gordon Kellett, with Quentin Smith in third place, and they've got a tiny gap back to Clive Pratt at the moment.
And Kellett well able to defend there, watching the mirrors and holding that inside line there. Smith's going to want to get back up there. Here we are again with Mark Turley at Dunlop Corner, down into second place. He's closing in on Kieran Sands. He's trying to get up the inside, possibly a little bit of contact. And there's Allison, and looks like Matt Dunn, but Allison holds that slide, gets the car sorted out and heads off down the straight.
It's pretty busy back in Fiat Punto Cup of Earth, back in midfield, and there's plenty of nudging and bumping and pouring. There's Mark Turley in the wars again, but he's making plenty of progress here. Of course, they're very experienced from the Dunlop Orty 2000 series, and Mark is certainly enjoying his return to Fiat action.
Mark's struggling a little bit in the straight line. They have a problem with that car. They're trying to sort it out. But out front now, it's the two guys. It looks like Smith certainly back up to second and already closed in on the back. These are two of the guys with the pace. And there's Richie Faulkner, reigning champion, struggling a little bit this year in that Murray Motorsport car. And Joey Freeburn right behind.
Yeah, Joey Freeburn's dropped back a little bit. And there we've got Clive Pratt just ahead of our cameraman, Liam Denning. Liam Denning making great progress. Looks as if he's got a run on Clive Pratt as they approach Dunlop Corner. He's down the inside. Can he go late enough on the brakes to get an advantage over Clive Pratt as they go side by side through the final corner, heading out down onto the main straight? He's inside Clive Pratt. Can he make it stick? Going to turn one.
It looks like Pratt's car quicker in a straight line and pulls right across there. Denning, no option but to go down the outside, breaking his lead as he tears and locking those front Dunlop tires. A little bit of a slide from Pratt, but that's good defensive driving, and he's still holding back the charging Liam Denning.
Liam Denning certainly on a charge, as you say, up front. Karl Leonard is making hay while Liam Denning is working his way up through them, and he's still got Clive Pratt in his sights. Up ahead of them is Gordon Kellett, and Gordon Kellett perhaps dropping off the lead two battle a little.
Back with Mark Turley now, and a dive down the inside of Paul Molloy, but watch out for the engine on this car. It's struggling a little bit, and here's Molloy down the outside, and Turley no option but to pull in behind that other car. Really going to have to get a bit of work done, but watch out for this guy when the car is sorted. We've seen him win Uno races, Punto races, and we will see him win Abarth races.
Well, Paul Molloy is fighting a defensive rearguard action there. Bill Griffin showing the spoils of war, the war wounds on his Bill Griffin motors machine. As we're on car with Mark Turley again, and Bill Griffin has just edged ahead of him, and it looks as if Mark Turley's got it all to do again if he's to get a run at Paul Molloy. Meanwhile, up front, we've got Karl Leonard, who looks confident. Just a little defend down there into Dunlop Corner, and he looks quite confident in. Oh, and there's Clive Pratt, really letting it all hang out.
Back out of Clive's car, let's go. They're still a little bit greasy on the entrance to Dunlop, but there's Denning fighting his way past Freeburn behind. And back on board again now with Denning. Let's have a look at this again. Pratt gets sideways. Denning gets a cliff from behind. It's all action in the Punto Abarth. Denning manages to hold on to it a little bit slow on the main straight. He's not happy with that one.
Well, Liam Denning certainly making his feelings shown. He didn't manage to capitalise on that mistake by Clive Pratt. And he's still chasing. And if anything, he's dropped a little bit further back behind the flying Carlo man, who now has a clear track and can chase up to the leading trio. And there we've got Karl Leonard dragging out a little bit of an advantage as they go into the second part of turn three. But as they come to the exit of it, it looks as if Quentin Smith is right with them. And they're going down to the S's. Quentin Smith's looking left, looking right. And Karl Leonard's having to look in his mirrors. This is not going to be an easy one. Showing plenty of scars of war there on his right-hand driver's door.
Certainly all about these two up front. And Smith looks like the man with the pace. He's weaving around behind Leonard. Watch Leonard. Very composed on the approach to Dunlop Corner. Doesn't really block too much. Doesn't defend. Very confident and very late on the brakes. Gordon Kellett there. Good to see him back up there. He had a few problems with the car. They're sorted out and he's right on the pace. Maguire now diving down the inside of Faulkner. Can he make it stick? A little bit of contact. Doesn't quite make it on that occasion.
Well, it looks as if he's got a bit of a run coming out of Dunlop Corner. Richie Faulkner defended and then ran back out and showed it to Dave Maguire. But up front, it's all action in the Nace Court Hotel car, with Karl Leonard ahead of the submarine bar car of Quentin Smith. It's the fight pubs here.
And Leonard going really well here, but certainly he's going to have to work for this one. Smith right back on the pace. There's a little bit of contact. That's Hay coming back up to the grid. Possibly Matt Dunn or Noel Green, one of the Ronnie Griffin cars. Back on board now with Turley again. And there's that Ronnie Griffin car, and he makes the most of it. Makes up another place on the inside.
Well, Noel Green managing to rejoin the action right at the back of the field. Plenty of action here. And these cars are a real handful. 170 brake horsepower from these 1800cc screamers. They're no easy car to handle.
And here we are on board again with Turley, and still even with the brake horsepower down, he's hanging on to these guys. He's really harassing them through the tight stuff. Billy Griffin, wing mirror flapping under huge pressure. Kieran Sands right in there as well, right in Turley's wheel. There you go, losing it all in a straight line. But watch him on the brakes down into Holiday in Ireland Corner, closing in on them again.
And Paul Molloy just about hanging on. And I don't think there's a car in the field that isn't showing damage. And certainly the panel beaters are going to have a result. Noel Green managing to tag on to that battle. Meanwhile, up front, it's still Karl Leonard defending. And look, Quentin Smith. Quentin Smith showed him, and he has a run down the inside. But it'll be Karl Leonard on the inside for turn two. And Karl just about manages to hold out. He's certainly been made to work for this one. Quentin Smith has the pace, as you say, and these two drawing away from the rest.
And Turley now, it looks like under pressure. Certainly one car gone by him, and it's Malloy on his way back up there, just driving by Turley on the main straight. Here's Turley tucking back in behind him. It's Noel Green actually in the Diffney car. There's Turley in that Argus car rentals machine. He's going to have that car sorted out, we said, and we'll see him up here with Carl Leonard. Here's Carl Leonard now, but Smith still all over him. Leonard maybe didn't defend, as we said earlier, and Smith didn't need to be asked twice, Declan.
Yeah, absolutely. Maybe he just waited a couple of laps and lulled him into a false sense of security, and Carl perhaps thought that that Quentin wasn't going to have a go. But you can be pretty sure of one thing, that Quentin is going to tough this one out right the way to the checkered flag, and Carl a lot further over to the middle of the track this time round. He's not going to just take a cruise around Dunlop Corner, and mind you, he makes a fantastic exit from that corner, still manages to make a good line, and if anything pulls out a bit of a gap as they come to the checkered flag. It's Carl Leonard from Quentin Smith with Gordon Kellett a welcome third.
So I got a great start, and I got in second very early because I knew it was a bit damp, so the Toro could pull me through. So basically got ahead of Quentin, and we had a race long dice, and it was very clean. So looking forward to the next one.
So it's two wins out of two for Leonard, with Smith second and Kellett scoring his first podium of the season. Here at Mondello for the Super Race Sunday, you don't have to wait for the racing for spectacular high-powered action. While the crews prepare for the Abarth Cup feature race, Terry Grant thrills the crowd with his amazing stunt display.
What stunts the Puntos get up to over the next 15 laps. And remember that Carl Leonard, the sprint winner, has to vault over at least the first four rows for a start off.
And as Emma says, Carl Leonard right back in eighth place. The reason for that, it's Super Race Sunday. The top eight are reversed. Bob Copeland on pole position alongside him, reigning champion Richie Faulkner, Joey Freeburn, Liam Denning, and Clive Pratt. We're on board again there with Liam Denning, you can see him in the mirror, and Mark Turley facing forward and back. Here we go now, third place in the greatest score, Joey Freeburn, Bob Copeland on that pole, watch out for him. And Copeland, it is a superb start, very experienced Fiat racer, went to RT2000s, didn't really work for him, but he's superb with these front wheel drive cars. Richie Faulkner going to try down the outside, but it looks like Copeland there from Murray Motorsport is going to hold the inside line. Treacherous conditions for these cars, expect them all to get very sideways. There's Allison out the back window, Mark Turley's car, and she's having a look alongside him. Allison already alongside Mark Turley, great drive from her, but certainly Copeland there, maybe Richie Faulkner getting a little bit crossed up, and Joey Freeburn getting a tip. It's all action on the front first lap of the Fiat Punto Abarth.
And there's Richie Faulkner, certainly made a mistake through turn two, and he's managed to gather it all up, but he has Liam Denning all over him. And Liam Denning, the championship leader, really wants to try and get ahead of as many cars as he can as soon as possible to get up the front before the field becomes strung out.
And now it's Copeland down into the S's. Denning trying everywhere. He was up the inside of turn three. Watch out for that deliverance car. We've seen Barry Rabbit on RPM before. Very quick driver in the wet. Graduated from Unos, reigning champion into Punto Abarth. On board again with Denning now. Round the second bit of the S's. Very bad conditions. He's going to try the inside, but Faulkner's wise with that. Will he try down the outside? He's all over the back. And a little bit of contact with Faulkner. Almost on the grass. Denning desperate to get by. He wants to get up and have a crack at Bob Copeland. He wants the lead because he knows Carl Leonard's coming behind.
Well, Richie Faulkner certainly has racecraft. He is the reigning champion in Fiat Punto Abarth. Remember that. Also a champion in former years in karts. And he knows all about racecraft. But I tell you, Liam Denning is the one with pace. And I'd be surprised if he's going to be able to keep him behind for much longer. And there's Clive Pratt really letting it hang out as he goes through turn one. These conditions treacherous. And really, it's putting it up to the drivers in these 170 brake horsepower screamers.
Leader Copeland cocks a rear wheel and he makes good his escape. But meanwhile, Gordon Kellett and Clive Pratt, two experienced campaigners, welded together.
And moving ahead a little bit, Bob Copeland still leading, but Barry Rabbit in the deliverance car has made plenty of progress. The reigning Fiat Uno champion really taking to these Fiat Punto Abarth Cup cars, and it's pretty hectic down there in midfield. You've got Quentin Smith and Clive Pratt behind him, and it's all action with the snazzybags.com car, the Ace Court Hotel car just ahead of him. The two Joe Murray prepared cars, identical in appearance, but that's Richie Faulkner just ahead of the first race winner, the sprint race winner this afternoon, Carl Leonard.
We've seen this from Leonard before. He takes a lap or two to get into it, and then he just comes scything up through the back. There he goes, down the inside of Faulkner, makes it look easy. Watch out for this guy progressing up the field. Meanwhile, Barry Rabbit up to third place. Watch out for this guy in the wet. We said, and we were right. Here's Quinton Smith trying to have a go around the outside of Richie Faulkner. He'll never make it stick there in the wet, and already Clive Pratt alongside as they go through the right-hander.
Well, meanwhile, up front, Bob Copeland is certainly enjoying his moment of glory. Hasn't been great for the last couple of years since he came out of Fiat Puntos as an absolute star, the Mickey Hakkinen look-alike. And meanwhile, there's mirrors flying. Richie Faulkner down the inside, Quentin Smith in the outside, and it looks as if Dave McGuire's going to get something out of that. He's right with them.
Well, Smith being very aggressive. Clive Pratt's not happy about that. He was having a really good run in this car. And here comes Smith again down the outside and turning across the front of Faulkner. Smith got stone crazy. Manages to hold that now in the AMF car. Gets it back in and contacts with Joey Freeburn. Quentin really all over the place here today.
Well, straight lines not designed into the submarine bar car this afternoon, and Quentin really struggling to keep it in all in a straight line. And that's Gordon Kellett, a podium from the first race, and he certainly will have enjoyed that. But he's got Karl Leonard right behind him, and he's going to have some serious defending to do any second.
And Karl Leonard, now, as you said, closing in on his teammate. He's disposed of Faulkner, he's moving in on Kellett, really making a name for himself in Murray Motorsport here. He came on board late, but he's absolutely flying in the Nace Cord Hotel car. There he is, working hard at the wheel, the Nace Cord Hotel DJ, and already he's round the outside of Gordon Kellett. That is an incredible manoeuvre. If he can make that stick, and he should do, he's on the inside. Here's Barry Rabbit up in third place. Rabbit can see Leonard coming, and he wants to have a go at these two guys in front.
Yeah, Rabbit on Denning, and that's pretty impressive stuff. Rabbit's new to this series, of course. Liam Denning is the pace of the series, and that's Joey Freeburn down the inside of Dave McGuire, as Richie Faulkner seems to be holding up this group, and they're certainly dropping back a little bit. Meanwhile, we're on board with Alison Lawford, and she can just see how incredibly treacherous these conditions are. Really struggling to hang on to it through the S's, takes to the grass.
But she does well to keep it all pointing in the right direction, regains the track, jumping ahead now, and it's still Copeland from Denning, but Leonard has displaced Rabbit. But these four really going well, and right behind them, the experience, Gordon Kellett. But Copeland under huge pressure now, and there goes Leonard down the inside of Denning, and leaving Denning right out onto the grass.
A pretty uncompromising manoeuvre there by Karl Leonard, but look at his car control. He really is enjoying these conditions. And Barry Rabbit, who was going so well in third place, looks as if he's slipping back further. He's got, is it Dave McGuire, right on top of him.
Gordon Kellett, that is in the TGA Fridays car, trying to get around the outside of Barry Rabbit. And Barry back down the inside, neck and neck now, heading for turn two. Barry has the inside line, apex two of turn three, I should say. And here he comes now, still holding onto that fourth place.
Pretty much impossible to make a pass around the outside of turn three. It's incredibly slippy down there. Slippy as part of this racetrack on a wet day. And it's a very slippy racetrack, as Karl Leonard doesn't really seem to have realised. Perhaps he thinks it's dry. That would certainly explain the way he's handling this Nace Cord Hotel car. Meanwhile, up front, Bob Copeland really enjoying his moment of glory, looks confident in the lead, but Karl Leonard's coming with him, and there's Liam Denning locking a wheel as he chases Karl Leonard.
Puff of smoke from the back of Karl Leonard's car every time he puts the power on there, but it looks like Copeland is next on his shopping list. He's making his way towards the front of this race. He's making it look easy.
Bob Copeland down the inside, Karl Leonard down the outside. That's the classic manoeuvre. Will Karl down the inside here a couple of laps ago. Oh, and Liam Denning right into the side of Karl Leonard. And that was pretty aggressive stuff. And Karl Leonard off to the left-hand side. Looks as if he's really struggling. He's dropped back into the clutches of Joey Freeburn. And disaster for Karl.
And his day isn't going to get much better, because we've got reports of a black flag for overtaking under yellows. Incredible after such a great drive from Karl Leonard. There's Quentin Smith now on the grass, and here's Mark Turley again down the inside of Noel Green into the S's. We've seen these two battling all afternoon. On board now with Turley, looking back at Green, who wants that place back, the back of that car, right under the bumper of Turley's car, really close on the wing mirror yet again, hanging off.
They've been battling all afternoon, a great battle right through the field, and there's Joe Murray handing out the pit board. He doesn't look too happy, and that's why, because his charged Karl Leonard is going down pit lane to answer that black flag call. And with him goes Quentin Smith, the front runner, and he's been called in as well, and there's a lot of consternation in this class. Meanwhile, up front, Bob Copeland has Joey Freeburn all over him.
And our man Liam Denning up the third. We're on board now with Liam. He's all over Joey Freeburn. He's going to the outside. Can he make this stick right round the outside of both these guys? This is incredible stuff from Denning. He just went round the outside. Nobody does that. Ayrton Senna did that years ago at Mandela Park. Now Liam Denning does it. He's all crossed up. He can't believe it. Look, he looks in the mirror. Can't believe it. I've just taken the lead.
It's established fact that you cannot go around the outside at that corner. He didn't just go around the outside of one car. He went around the outside of two. He didn't just do that, but he gained about three car lengths doing it. An incredible manoeuvre. And I think there was oil down there, which meant that Joey Freeburn and Bob Copeland were being a little bit cautious. But Liam Denning, he decided he could go around the outside, and obviously a better line, better grip there. And there's an incredible amount of damage on that car. You've got wing mirrors hanging off it. You've got spoilers hanging off it. And Joey Freeburn looking for a place down the inside. There is no inside line there. Incredible defensive work there from Liam Denning. He's up from fourth on the grid to lead this race. He's got Joey Freeburn on one side. He's got Bob Copeland on the other. But Liam Denning in the lead. Incredible performance from the Dubliner.
Denning will be delighted with this. That was an incredible move. Here he comes down to the first corner again, defending heavily. He doesn't mind if the pace slows down. The back end of the car breaks away, but he holds it. That's not a problem. Copeland now and Joey Freeburn neck and neck, and this should allow Liam Denning to make that little bit of a happy gap.
Grip levels considerably reduced on this Mondello National Circuit this afternoon, and really the mixture of oil and water isn't suiting the handling of these cars, and it's the real driving talent that is to the fore now. We're seeing Liam Denning up front, and Bob Copeland, a man with peerless car control, in second place. A good run for him. Joey Freeburn fancies a run down the outside. He's seen that done very recently, but no, he has to tuck in behind Bob Copeland. And those three in line astern as they head down towards the S's.
Gordon Kellett now being dropped by these three, but hanging on well there in fourth place. And Barry Rabbit still right there. There's Bob Copeland working at the wheel in the Edgeform Metals car. Still under pressure. He was back to third. He's up to second now. He'd be happy with second. He's still getting the hang of these Punto Abarth cars. But here was a man we spoke about, Liam Denning, still being defensive, even though he's got three, 4 lengths behind him. He doesn't want to lose this lead.
Yeah, I think he is expecting someone to be on top of him. He probably can't believe his luck, although it was no luck there. It was judgment on that incredible pass that he did a couple of laps ago. And there's Joey Freeburn down the inside of Bob Copeland, but he hasn't really got a run at him. He's still a car length behind and Bob Copeland, a couple of car lengths really.
Freeburn now out of the slipstream and dives down the outside. A brave move, but quite often there's grip around the outside on a wet day here at Mondello Park, and it looks like he can possibly make it stick. But no, Copeland well able for him and uses all the road on the way out, not being too generous with the road. On to the last lap now. Liam Denning looks like he can stroke this home for a well-deserved victory.
Yeah, Denning has opened up a gap. He looks in control, and Copeland really now has to think about defending from Joey Freeburn, not for the first time this afternoon. I think thoughts of the win are gone really, and this is still a good result for Bob Copeland. Hasn't been so good. Look at Joey Freeburn down the outside. He knows this can be done. He fancies trying. He's been trying this outside line, and he's made it stick. He's learned there from Liam Denning that you can get a run down the outside into turn three. He now has the inside line for the S's, and Joey Freeburn looks as if he's got himself into second place. Good result there for the Armagh man. Hasn't been going so well for him this season, and he has been a front runner right from the very beginning of the Fiat Punto Abarth Cup series. Meanwhile, Liam Denning coming through the S's, as you say, still defending, still going down the inside, and he has like a 3-length car length advantage going down into the final turn. Freeburn doing the same thing right up the inside, and Freeburn's right with him. Denning just coasting, just stroking it down to the flag. Copeland in third place. Well, that's a great win, a fantastic win there for Liam Denning.
Yeah, it was the most amazing race. I kind of was going up and down the field, and I got an opportunity down Duckham's down the outside, which I thought I would take a chance because Bob was holding up Joey. I was either going to kill or cure, and it worked well for me.
So it's 2 wins from 4 for Liam Denning this season, with Joey Freeburn and Bob Copeland making welcome podium visits. Denning still holds sway at the top of the championship table, with Smith still very much in touch. Liam Denning had been the big winner in the first 9 rounds of the Fiat Punto Abarth Cup Championship, but by mid-season, Karl Leonard was really showing a considerable turn of speed. Had the Nace hotelier left it too late to challenge the Dublin car body repair specialist, the August Super Race Sunday meeting at Mondello could be Leonard's last chance to challenge the 2003 championship. The qualifying action is as hot as the weather here at Mondello Park as the Fiat Punto Abarth series reaches fever pitch. 20 minutes of timed lapping of Mondello's national circuit for the teams and drivers to maximise their qualifying positions for the 12-lap sprint race. The results of that race will decide the grid order for the later 20-lap feature race, with the top 8 positions reversed to add an extra challenge for the leading drivers. And at the end of another busy session for the busiest class in the Super Race Sunday package, Dublin title rivals Quentin Smith and championship leader Liam Denning have had to give best to on-form Kildare man Karl Leonard, the latter very much the man to beat since he arrived late into the series. Let's meet the top 3 on the grid.
very, very tight there. I think there's only 300 of a second between myself and Liam. Karl, I think, is 2/10 quicker than him, but he got a good clear run. There was a lot of traffic out there, and as the session went on, it actually got slower. So I came in halfway through it and just let the car cool down because I knew I wasn't going to go any quicker.
Liam getting a comfortable championship lead, but Karl Leonard's really putting it up to you, isn't he?
Yeah, Karl's going very well. He's on pole this morning. I was hoping to get pole, but second is the next best thing.
Pole position. So I need to get a few points back on Liam. He's about 30 points ahead in the championship. So hopefully today, as I got pole, hopefully I can cap it off with a win.
Murray Motorsports are one of a number of specialist preparation companies to prepare cars for the Fiat Punto Abarth Cup Series. Joe Murray and his mechanics look after the cars of Paul Malloy, Gordon Kellett and Alison Lawford. And all three of them have strong connections with the motor trade. Fiat dealers, one would assume.
Paul, Fiat.
They certainly race them all right, Plum, but we're actually a Ford dealer, so that's what we do for bread and butter.
Gordon, Fiat.
Well, we drive Fiats, but I'm afraid we're in the motor trade, all right, but we sell Saab cars in Dublin City, but we race Fiats.
Racing Fiat, yes, but it's actually a Nissan background I come from. Our family have a Nissan dealership in Harold's Cross in Dublin.
Well, Joe Murray is the man tasked with preparing the cars for these motor training drivers.
So Joe, this looks like a standard Fiat Punto to me. What changes have to be made to turn it into a race car?
Well, Emma, to start with, the engine is effectively a standard 1.8 16 valve unit found in the HGT Punto Abarth. We then strip out the complete interior and we fit a very substantial roll cage, so in the event of an accident the driver is unhurt. We also fit a proper safety racing seat and fire extinguisher. Upgraded brakes and suspension all round, and that effectively is your Fiat Punto Abarth racing car.
So how many hours does it take to change this into a racing car?
Approximately 150 man hours.
They may like to sell Ford, Saabs and Mazdas during the week, but they get their kicks out of driving Fiats at the weekend.
And so as the season comes to a fever pitch, it couldn't have been better organised because the top two men in the championship are on the front two rows of the grid. Yes, Karl Leonard in pole position, Liam Denning second, then Smith, then Freeburn with one of our cameras, Malty, our speaking cameraman, and that's the lineup, a packed grid at the Mondello National Circuit. We're looking back with Joey and looking forward and listening with Leo.
Going out up onto our spot, fifth in the grid. We've got to watch out for Clive Pratt on the right-hand side and Nigel on the left. But again, if I get the jump on Nigel, maybe we'll take a run down the left-hand side. We'll see which way this goes.
Our third onboard camera is with Paul Malloy, who's towards the back of the field and a lot of work to do.
Karl Leonard on pole position, and as he has been so often this year, Liam Denning alongside, and certainly we're expecting a packed and frenetic race this afternoon here at Mondello's National Circuit. The revs rise, the lights are out, and Liam Denning makes a fantastic start from second on the grid. And has he managed to get ahead of Karl Leonard as they run to the front first corner? He certainly has. Liam Denning defending down the inside, Karl Leonard looking left and right to try and get away fast, and there's Joey Freeburn in third place. We're looking back at
Smith, and there's Leonalti, our talking cameraman, coming through and leaning on Smith there. A lot of paint being swapped already.
Fabulous performance from Leo. There he is in the Calzini's Fiat Punto Abarth this afternoon. Hasn't been out regularly in the series, but he doesn't forget how to drive, and he's right all over Quinton Smith as they head down into turn three.
In fact, old Smith just slipped ahead of him there as they go out, but the first three are breaking away. The championship leader Denning now challenging Carl Smith. In fact, he might have been ahead there, and look at that. That's Maguire getting close attention there from Gordon Kellett.
Gordon Kellett right on his tail and a little bit further back than he would have anticipated. Looks like the leading three are opening up something of an advantage, and Karl Leonard looked to the inside there as they come through Dunlop Corner at the end of lap one, but Liam Denning had that one covered. Joey Freeburn very much in attendance, looking to make a run down the outside as they go across the start finish line to end lap one.
But it's Liam Denning, the championship leader, Karl Leonard, the man who was in pole position but made that rather slow start in second place, and Joey Freeburn going a little bit wide to get a good look at these three. And these three are pulling away. In fourth place, Smith. In fifth place, I'm talking cameraman. And in sixth, Fitzgerald.
Third gear already giving trouble there. Not that happy with that down at the third. Back on the power. She's out of third gear. We still have second. I think that third gear definitely going to give us trouble. Got to run up the hill at Quentin here. Still managing to get that third, but I'm not that happy. It's going to last the race. Down into second again here. This is where we need to keep it steady. Get a good run there.
So gear selection problems for our cameraman Leo Nolte, but he's managing to hang on to Quentin Smith there, and Quentin is just about managing to get on the fingertails, the coattails of the battle ahead of him. Meanwhile, Fitzgerald being passed by one of the Pratt brothers down into Dunlop Corner, and he's in a Pratt sandwich there as they head down at the end of lap two.
Nigel Pratt is in the pink one, and it was Clive Pratt on the blue one, and look at this, that's Fiat Racing at its very best, trying to squeeze for about four punters in the space for two.
Naughty boy flags going out. There's always plenty of paint swapping in this class. Meanwhile, on board with Leo.
There's third gear gone. That's us out of the race. Oh, well, we had a feeling that was going to happen.
Paul Molloy there passing Leonardo's ailing car. They have to try and get it back to the pits and get it fixed for the feature race. They have a lot of work to do. Meanwhile, Paul has his own little battle up front here, because just ahead of him is Kieran Sands in the white car there.
And Kieran Sands just ahead of, as you say. And now down the inside, that's Karl Leonard for the lead on Liam Denning. A little bit of paint being swapped. There's a hell of a lot of rubbing. They're both almost out on the dirt there. An incredible manoeuvre there by Karl Leonard. He's managed to get the lead. And along with him, Joey Freeburn has got into second place. So disaster for Liam Denning up at Dunlop Corner.
And we see Kieran Smith now, Quinton Smith, I should say, trying to come down the outside. And Liam Denning, that's been a very, very costly lap for him indeed. He doesn't need to do that, because Karl Leonard is one man that can really close the points. So it's Leonard, then Joey Freeburn, who we're riding with now in second place. Then Liam Denning, the championship leader, in third place. And right behind him, Quentin Smith. These four are what it's all about in this race.
So Smith's come from behind and he's right with the lead battle. Meanwhile, up front, Karl Leonard's car showing the scars of battle. It's no easy thing to pull off an overtaking manoeuvre in Fiat Punto Abarth Racing, the closest form of saloon racing. And Liam Denning's mirror is flopping free there on the right side, and he's trying to get by Joey Freeburn. He's crawling all over the back of this car. And meanwhile, Quentin Smith very much with him, so he has to look at in his mirrors, the one mirror he's got left, as he pulls an overtaking manoeuvre down the inside into Dunlop. Has he made it stick? Certainly there's a bit of contact there, and Quentin Smith down the outside of Liam Denning. So it's all happening as they finish this lap.
Well, the Super Race Sunday crowd's really loving this one as they come down to complete another lap. So there's Joey Freeburn in the black and yellow car. Quentin Smith, the third of that group, harrowing Denning there, who's in the middle of it all. And then beginning to catch it up now with one of the Pratt brothers. In fact, the two Pratt brothers. But unfortunately, Leo's day is done.
Oh, third gear's gone, Paul. It's been a little bit weak since we first tested the car yesterday. But we had a great run. I've been right with the leaders there. Missed third a couple of times and finally got away. I thought I was going to hold it in gear, but it's just completely gone now.
So a lot of work to be done by the mechanics before the second. Clive Pratt then in the blue car leads Nigel Pratt in the number 18 there in the pink car.
Meanwhile, Joey Freeburn is still trying to keep Liam Denning behind him, and Karl Leonard is making hay while the sun shines, and it certainly is at Montello here this afternoon. The two Pratt brothers still working, and I wonder, is Nigel going to have a crack at Clive down into that first corner? Not this lap, not quite close enough, and I wonder if they'll play tag and try and get on the lead group.
So it's Clive leads Nigel, the two Pratt brothers from Carlo, Fiat agents and very, very enthusiasts. Been racing various forms of Fiat for many years now around Mandello. Great sports, really love the weekend's motorsport.
Immaculately presented cars they are too. Really, they've presented them in a fantastic manner here this afternoon as they run through turn three, chasing that group. Meanwhile, a little bit further back, this is Paul Molloy. He's chasing Kieran Sands. And then look at that sideways moment from Dave McGuire. And that's allowing these three to close up.
And Brendan Fitzgerald is in the yellow car. He's the other one in that bunch. And you can see that look of concentration on Paul Molloy's face as he tries to get down the inside there of Kieran Sands, but doesn't succeed this time. And Alison Lawford there is right on his tail.
It's all action everywhere in this Fiat Punto Abarth grid. Kieran Sands jinks to the left. He's got Fitzgerald on his right-hand side ahead. And meanwhile, just looking up the inside, that's Paul Molloy. And this group is scrambling to chase on to the next group ahead. But it looks as if Kieran Sands might have a run on Brendan Fitzgerald as they chase down to the first corner.
Indeed, and he's got, he should have it now under braking. Very late in the brake, he's in the right position. Paul Molloy's trying to go back with him. In fact, Paul Molloy on the inside, can he keep in enough power? But it's on the wrong side now as they go through the left-hander and out into the country again.
Fitzgerald, a bit of a loser there, didn't work out for him. Meanwhile, Alison Lawford is getting a run at Paul Molloy down the outside towards turn three. No easy job to try and pull off an overtaking manoeuvre there. Meanwhile, up front, serenely moving on, that's Karl Leonard. And it looks as if Joey Freeburn's got a bit of a gap on Liam Denning. His car showing the smiles of battle, and there, well, that was Quentin Smith down the outside on Denning, didn't quite manage to make it stick.
So that's where the real battle is now for third place. We see the two Pratt brothers, who seem to have swapped positions incidentally in the background, but it's Quentin Smith trying to pass the dummy, as they say in motor racing, going one side and then juking to the other, but it didn't work because Liam Denning is a very wily racer. Two very experienced men in combat here.
Looks as if Nigel Pratt has passed Clive and working his way onto the tail of that battle. So a bit of a swap there between the Pratt brothers, and it looks as if Nigel has got the pace to get close to this battle, and perhaps they're slowing themselves up a little bit in their frenetic efforts to keep each other behind and of course to put the pass on the man in front. And certainly it hasn't settled down yet in this race. It's all action right throughout the field.
First and second looks pretty well settled at this stage between Karl Leonard and Joey Freeburn, but third is far from settled as these two battle it to the flag. Karl Leonard then coming up to Dunlop for the last time, but all eyes are in the third place battle. Number five there, Liam Denning, defending his line. It doesn't look like Quinton Smith can take it at this stage. Leonard wins. Joey Freeburn is second, and we have Liam Denning third.
Had a very bad start. Liam got the traction off the line, and basically I was fuming myself, and I took a dive. I was diving all around the track to see if I could get past, and I took an opportunist move up the top with trade of paint, and I just got by.
Over the next 15 laps, these identical tin tops are going to be added hammer and tongs.
Hammer and tongs indeed for round 11 in the Fiat Punto Abarth Cup. And just to add spice, as always, the grid has been reversed from that sprint race, which means that we've now got Liam Rabbit on the front row with Bill Griffin, then the two Pratt brothers, and then Quinton Smith, Denning and Freeburn, all the men that were up there front in the first race, way back down in the middle of the pack. Barry Rabbit, then number 25, in pole position. Alongside him will be Bill Griffin, very much a veteran, but a very good driver indeed. And this time we're looking forward for Joey Freeburn, and Leo Nulty is back.
Alison Lawford not right, lining up in the right place. That doesn't suit us, really does not suit us.
So Leo right at the back there, right at the back in our camera car. We'll be watching for action there, but Barry Rabbit, a chance to redeem his difficult season from pole position. Bill Griffin, a wily old veteran, alongside him in second place. And Barry looks as if he's nailed the start, looks as if he's going to take the lead as the field streams down towards turn one. It's Barry Rabbit and one of the Clive Pratt, it is. Nigel Pratt in third place, and round the outside, Karl Leonard, where does he come from? Eighth on the grid, looks as if he's gone around the first corner with a nudge in fourth position.
Bill Griffin made a terrible start that time. He went from the front row right back into fourth or fifth place. And there's on one of our camera cars, the black car of Joey Freeburn. We're on board with him now, trying to make up places.
Joey Freeburn down the inside of Dave McGuire, and at least he's trying there. Just ahead of him, Gordon Kellett, as the field streams through turn three. Difficult corner this, and it looks as if Freeburn's trying inside, outside on Dave McGuire. Nothing he can do. The pack very much bunched up at the moment. But meanwhile, Nigel Pratt is there all over, climbing all over Karl Leonard there. An incredible start by Karl Leonard to have got up to fourth position from eighth on the grid right into turn one. And Karl Leonard showing his peerless racecraft this season.
Freeburn in the battles, as is Leo.
Back down the inside is what we're looking for here. We should have it.
Leo looks as if he has a good run down the inside. He's gone onto the tail off Brendan Fitzgerald's car as they go down the start, past the start finish line, under the Vodafone Bridge. He switches to the outside and he's looking to make a really clean, quick exit. Incredible manoeuvre there, late braking by the other cars. Looks as if he's got a run down the outside into turn two. Has he made the pass on at least one of those cars?
Both by Sean Woods there.
Meanwhile, we have another man making considerable progress, and that's the race one winner. And of course, there's the Pratts. One of the Pratts has gone off. Clive Pratt got off, and look at the amount of time he's losing there. A bad, bad mistake. Cars, Puntos streaming past him. He must have lost at least six places there.
Incredible that he actually managed to gather it up. He was looking out the back window halfway through that manoeuvre, but he's still back on track. Meanwhile, Karl Leonard has managed to move up, and there's our race. There's Barry Rabbit. His season, his disastrous season, just gets worse. Disaster, and it looks as if now Nigel Pratt has taken it up from Bill Griffin. So we don't know what happened to Barry Rabbit there. Disaster for him. Meanwhile, Liam Denning's into fourth place and closing on this lead battle. And this Karl Leonard is in the lead. Incredible. Karl Leonard is in the lead from eighth on the grid.
A brilliant drive. Absolutely brilliant. Just what he needs to try and keep his championship hopes alive. But Liam Denning is making useful points. No luck for Barry Rabbit today. That's him out after a dismal season, as we already heard. We're on board now with Leonard.
And he's got a great run through turn two on Brendan Fitzgerald. A little bit of paint swapping there as he got a run down the outside. Fitzgerald giving him the minimum amount of room and no more. But it looks as if Leo down the outside into turn three. You can't pull that manoeuvre off with ease. Incredible stuff.
A good bit of panel bashing there, Fitzgerald. We got round the outside of turn two. Turn three, that's a really hairy manoeuvre. I hope my mum doesn't get frightened watching that on the telly. Oh, he's down the inside, looks like he's going to give us a bit of a nudge. There we go. Okay, Brendan.
It's fast and frenetic stuff in the middle of the Fiat Punto Abarth pack, but it looks as if Leonelti's making plenty of progress and he's chasing up onto that midfield group as he works his way through turn four and out onto the end of that lap.
Joey Freeburn, we're with him now, and we're trying to make our way up through the field as well, because remember, he suffered from that reverse grid situation.
And meanwhile, that's Noel Green, and look at Joey Freeburn down the outside, kicking up the dust at the exit of turn one. And the outside there, that's Gordon Kellett. Noel Green on the inside, the Rathfarnham man, has done a great job in Fiat Puntos last season, and he's certainly doing very well on his graduation to Fiat Punto Abarth on the brakes. And there's Gordon Kellett giving it a little bit on the way into turn three. And a fine battle here between two champions in many classes over the years. Joey Freeburn is certainly not going to find it easy to work his way up onto the tail of the leaders.
So number four, Gordon Kelly, just ahead of him there, a man who's been racing for must be, oh, at least a dozen years. There's Maguire just behind him, another very experienced Fiat racer.
Dave Maguire won in the Phoenix Park back in 1993 in the debut of the Fiat Unos, I seem to remember. Meanwhile, Noel Green is doing a fantastic job of holding this group up. We're back on board with Leo. He's caught Joey Freeburn.
Now we've got two onboard cameras virtually fighting with each other. We're on board with Joey Freeburn, and right on his tail will be Leo Nalty at this stage.
Freeburn down the outside of Kellett as they work their way towards turn one. He's hardly going to be able to make it down the outside unless he breaks incredibly late. But it's a fantastic manoeuvre by Joey Freeburn. If he can hang on into turn two, he's got the advantage there. And it looks as if Kellett has had to cede that place to Joey Freeburn. A fine manoeuvre, not easily put over on a man like Gordon Kellett.
While all that was going on, Karl Leonard is going on his winning way. What a weekend he's having. Nigel Pratt in second place there in the pink car. The Carlo men seem to specialise in fairly lurid colour schemes. Not so the more conservative Nice Court Hotel car. But it's doing the business today.
And Karl Leonard very comfortable in the lead there. He's not taking too much curb on the exit of corners, driving well within himself, and really he manages to circulate this Mondello Park National Circuit at about 80%, and yet it's a lap time that many other drivers in the field would aspire to. And really he's very comfortable as he wends his way towards an unlikely double this weekend. If he manages to pull off this feature race win from 8th on the grid, it'll be something else.
Meanwhile, Leo Nalty trying to make up more positions. They've really worked hard to get this car back on the grid, and Leo is certainly repaying them here with a sterling drive.
Leo and the Calzini's Fiat Punto Abarth on the tail of Gordon Kellett, the man who he vied with the Fiat Punto for the Fiat Punto title last year. And that's Nigel Pratt on the grass up at turn three. How in the hell did he get in the middle of the circuit? That's incredible.
So Nigel Pratt, who was in second place, making a big, big mistake. Freeburn now coming up to try and take him. There's Freeburn on his tail in car number two. But Nigel Pratt really throwing it all away there in the closing stages of this race.
And that was to the benefit of Bill Griffin, who's now up into third place. And Liam Denning in second place for the second time this afternoon. And Bill Griffin, a former Formula Ford racer, in third place. This Karl Leonard, a fantastic victory, a fantastic double from Liam Denning with Bill Griffin in third.
I started eighth and came around the two corners and I was up into third and I just went from there, and Barry had a huge lead and he obviously had a problem, he pulled in.
Billy Griffin, your third place finish of the season. Now you're making a habit of this.
Yeah, it's getting good. I'm starting to enjoy it at my young age.
Are you? You're certainly back racing now. You're back in the rhythm of it.
I am. I'm back in the rhythm of it. Hopefully, finish out the end of the year. I have a son now, Dave, that's 17. He wants to do it, so we're tossing the coin who gets it next year.
So you're going to be retiring at the end of the year?
Well, I retired about five times already, so we'll see you next year.
Liam Denning, second place, mission accomplished.
Yeah, it was great. The first corner, I got caught up in between traffic, and Karl just got a super start. He was gone, and I couldn't catch him.
I'd say you were thrilled to see Nigel spinning off in the last lap.
I couldn't believe me. Look, I just settled for third place. It was a 15 lap race, and I was getting tired, and so was the car. And when he spun off in Duckham, I just thought it was just my day.
So you pretty much have the title in the bag now. 20 points up, 22 points up with two rounds to go.
Yeah, all I have to do is finish in the top 10 now, and I have a one.
So Leonard completes a tremendous double, with Denning looking into second and Billy Griffin a delighted third. But it looks as if it's come too late for Leonard, with Denning holding a commanding lead as the series heads towards a conclusion, but Karl looks secure in second. We come to the climax of the season's running for the Fiat Punto Abarth Cup racers. Although the tyres, engines and general specification of these 1800cc screamers are identical, the season has been about just two racers so far this season, Karl Leonard and Liam Denning, who have managed to win every championship round to date. Now with just two rounds remaining, it's time for the shootout.
The old story is that Liam has chosen not to use the new shape Punto for fear of a protest, which could jeopardise his championship chances. So he has elected instead to use Mark Fairley's Argus car. Michael Barrable, who is in contention for the National Rally Championship, is in the guest car this weekend. Michael, back to your roots.
Yes, we've turned the clock right back. We've come back to Mandello for the Punto Abarth race today. I've had an opportunity to drive the celebrity car, thanks to Oisin. And just here this morning is our first run on the car. It's actually my first time in Mandello since 1996. And it's quite a daunting experience, especially I've never driven anything like this before in my life.
In qualifying third fastest is veteran racer Gordon Kellett, who is in with a shout for third place in the championship.
The car has finally got itself sorted, or maybe the driver's got himself sorted, but we're pretty well on the pace this morning. A little bit more, hopefully, and maybe we'll get up to the front row in the next race.
Quinton Smith is on the front row, and he is also in with a shout for that third place championship fight. Quinton, front row.
Yeah, I'm happy with that now. I got a good out qualifying there. Karl got a nice qualifying, got a good time fairly early on in the stage. I knew I wasn't going to go any quicker, so I sort of conserved my tyres for the races, because I know for a fact that he's quite low for tyres for the race. So hopefully my strategy will play off for me in the race.
But the series shootout is between Liam Denning, the multiple Fiat champion from Rathfarnham, and the local driver from Nace, Karl Leonard. Between them, they have won every race to date, with Karl topping the wins table with six, after Liam has won five. But Liam has been on the podium nine times to Karl's eight. With all the cars built to identical specification and all racing on identical Dunlop tyres, it's amazing that more people have not been in the frame this year. And it's almost been a clean fight to date, well, as clean as Fiat racing ever gets. Well, Although Liam is ahead on points, he only qualifies in sixth place, leaving the door open to a late reversal in fortune.
Fifth isn't ideal today. I was hoping for maybe first or second, unfortunately.
So does this put more pressure on the old championship lead?
No, I have two races to do it in, and basically I have to finish neither one of the races just behind Karl. But I don't think I'll come second in the first race.
Karl, who's been the king at Mandela, again tops the times and sits on pole position.
Karl, this is the day you've got to do it, and you've done it in qualifying.
Yeah, delighted. The lads just told me I'm on pole there by 2 or 3 tenths, so I'm delighted. So I'm looking for a good result.
And so we come to the 12th and penultimate round of the 2003 Fiat Abarth Cup. With everything to play for, and Matt Feeney joins me in commentary for the final Fiat fling.
Well, yes, the final Fiat fling it may well be, but Karl Leonard is the man who has annexed pole position. Alongside him then, on the front of the grid, is Quentin Smith, Gordon Kellett and Dave McGuire lock out row 2. Then on row 3, we have Bob Copeland and Liam Denning. On row 4, we have Barry Rabbit and Noel Green. Row 5 then has Joey Freeburn and Bill Griffin. Row 6 has Nigel Pratt and Brian Hayde. And working right back to the end of the field, we have Brendan Fitzgerald.
We're on board with Michael Barrable, feeling a little bit nervous, no doubt, at this time. It must be Quinton Smith, who's on the front row, alongside the man who really has to win this one to stay on the championship hunt. And he makes an excellent start, does Karl Leonard.
Well, will it be Leonard or will it be Smith as they head down to the first corner? That is Smith on the outside, Leonard on the inside, and then looking backwards to the two protagonists behind. We have Dave McGuire there and Gordon Kellett just slotting into third place as they come through the right-hander. Quentin Smith now tucking in behind Karl Leonard as they swing left, and they're out on the grass. A little bit of grass cutting there for Gordon Kellett in fourth. Bob Copeland running there in fifth.
But Karl Leonard has done it absolutely right. He's out of trouble. He's up front at the moment. That's just where he needs to be. And we're looking to see where the other championship man is. He looks as he's down in either fifth or sixth place.
Well, he's in sixth place at the moment, coming around the outside there, picking him up another spot, and that brings him up to fifth now as he tucks in behind Bob Copeland there, coming through the left-hander then at Holiday in Ireland corner, swinging right. He'll want to improve his position. He's got to finish behind Karl Leonard, or as near to Karl Leonard as he possibly can. And they come down under braking then into Dunlop.
Not in too much of a panic, remember, at the moment, because he has that 22 points advantage. But look at all these little screaming Fiat Punto Abarths, 1800 cc's, working to maximum power and already pulling out the first two. So Karl Leonard pulling away with him is Quinton Smith. And Quinton Smith, who hasn't had a win this year, obviously very keen to get maximum points and get up into that third championship position.
Well, he's hanging on well at the moment to Karl Leonard, and a bit of a gap opening back to the third place man, who's Gordon Kellett, and Gordon leading a train there of Bob Copeland and that man Liam Denning.
And that was fabulous Fiat stuff as they went up onto three wheels, cocking the rear wheel. Very typical. They're as strong and as hard suspension as you can get in these little cars. Therefore, they bounce around a lot at Mandela.
Well, you see all that bouncing there as they come through the left-hander. We have the rear view out of Karl Leonard's car, looking at Quentin Smith. We're on board now with Smith coming down into Dunlop.
Dunlop corner, Smith's in second place, number 6 there, Karl Leonard leading, of course, then we've got Kellett in third place, and then Copeland, and then the championship leader just behind him, and then a bit of a gap with the bunch being led by Joey Freeburn.
Well, this is important for Joey Freeburn. Joey is looking to get third place in the championship, and he's leading a gaggle of cars there, and Noel Green coming through on the inside there, a good run from him, but on the outside being hooshed out there ever so slightly at the moment is Dave McGuire, and he's dropped back down from row 2 of the grid to find himself battling away midfield.
Green there losing out badly, getting put out there. There's a lot of talent in that bunch. Look at Bill Griffin there, number 8. Look at Liam Rabbit. They've been Fiat racing for years and they know how to dispute space, and that's what they're doing at the moment.
Well, in fact, the Rabbits, of course, a great family of racers, and Barry Rabbit, in fact, that's in the car today. His uncle Liam, also a great Fiat racer, but Barry behind the wheel there, but coming under all sorts of pressure now from Bill Griffin as they stream through your shot, with Noel Green there tucking in right behind.
getting dangerously close to our cab camera as they come up the hill to Dunlop one more time. This is the battle for about fourth or fifth place. Of course, the championship contenders, well, it's even lower than that. It's about seventh or eighth place. There's Bill Griffin, number eight, just trying to go inside Barry Rabbit there as they come down the main straight. They're all chasing Maguire at the moment.
Well, Lee Maguire in all sorts of problems now as Bill Griffin has closed up behind him and Barry Rabbit tucking in there as they go around the right-hander. Brian Haidt seems to have the run on him as they come out of that corner. Door handle to door handle then as they sweep through the left-hander, and Nigel Pratt getting involved in a battle of his own there. Clive Pratt in the bluer car just going through shot.
And look at Clive Pratt's car closely when you get a chance, because that's the new shape car. The car that in fact this man should have been racing but chose not to in case it slightly infringed the championship regulations. Anyway, he's played it safe, and he's playing it pretty safe at the moment, because there he is on the right of your screen at the moment, just behind Copeland, and he's got it all wrong. And I'd say playing it safe, it's a disaster for the championship leader.
Well, there's Liam Denning then, right, burying himself in the gravel there at Dunlop. So that looks like his championship certainly is going to have to wait until race two. But meanwhile, out in front, gifted now, Karl Leonard is extending that. It's like as though he telepathically understood that his contender for the championship had gone off, because he seemed to increase his lead still further on that lap.
Christmas has come early today for Karl Leonard. This has opened up the championship with one round still to go. Haidt is leading this little bunch. There's one of the Pratts in the middle there in the very distinct little pink car, which had quite a special colour scheme. And right behind him, Paul Molloy in the Ford Motors car.
Well, Paul Molloy certainly keeping him honest, the more modest blue-shaped machine of Paul Molloy. But Nigel Pratt is having none of it. He goes alongside Molloy, then you're Molloy on the near side, Pratt on the outside, and they run door handle to door handle. Little bit of touching coming through there. We're not surprised to see this in Fiat racing. It's part and parcel of the package, as they say.
There's not a panel on any one of these cars at the end of the season that is exactly the way it should have come out of the showroom. But look at Karl Leonard, takes the checkered flag, maximum points, exactly running it. A fabulous, fabulous result for Karl Leonard. And a good result too for Smith. And in the background there up at Dunlop, that just means disaster, I'm afraid, for Paul Molloy, who lets Nigel Pratt through on the very last lap.
Another race win, but Liam Denning in the gravel top. Looks like the championship's wide open.
Yeah, it's great results. Basically, I won the race, and Liam, as you can see, is up above there in the gravel trap, so it's the best result I could have got. It's great.
Okay, and the car going really well. You're going to start sixth in race two?
Yeah, I'm starting in sixth place, so hopefully we'll change the tyres, and hopefully we can get up to the front again.
Well, no wonder Liam Denning looked a bit miserable there. No points on the table with one round to go. And Karl Leonard now with his pecker really up and a real chance of a title this year.
12 hard races have been run over the year, and now one battle between the Fiat Abarth remains. And despite taking a 22-point disadvantage into the weekend, Karl Leonard has somehow managed to keep the 2003 championship open to the final round. And all the action is back here at the middle of the grid.
Well, we really couldn't have asked for more for the final round of the Fiat Abarth Cup, because this is a dramatic grid.
And up pole position we have Brian Haidt. Alongside him then at the front of the grid is Billy Griffin. Row 2 has Dave Maguire and Joey Freeburn. Row 3 has Bob Copeland and Gordon Kellett. Row 4 has Quentin Smith. And yes, you guessed, that man Karl Leonard. But right at the end of the field, seeking the elusive championship win, is Liam Denning.
And boy, has he got work to do. Because we've got 5 seconds to go before the start. There's Liam Denning's view. It's dramatic stuff. Michael Bearable, of course, in the guest car, all ready to go. Packed field of Fiats. The tension rises for the final round. Who's going to make the good starts? Clean off the front row. We're looking for the championship contenders, though, down amongst the field, and particularly Liam Denning.
Well, here they come then into the first corner. Billy Griffin coming around here on the outside in the silver car with Brian Haidt on the inside, and already we can see that Argus car has picked up about 7 spots.
Oh, amazing, in 1 or 2 corners, and he's keeping out of trouble. Karl Leonard's out of trouble there also, but somebody on the grass there, that's Michael Bearable. Ready, man, he should be used to it.
Well, he's well used to that, and there goes our curb camera, and I think that was Quentin Smith who we're going to be sending a bill to for that. But on board with Liam Denning, and look at the concentration on Liam Denning's face as he tries to work himself through the field.
But ahead of Karl Leonard, there's a car on fire. That's Maguire's car on fire. Keller
Leonard's in contention there also. So the Nice Court Hotel trying to keep out of trouble. And we just got a glimpse of the championship leader carving his way through this field. But look at this car. Surely he must know, Maguire must know, he's a big bother.
He certainly is, but look what has happened in the meantime. Karl Leonard now looks in his rearview mirror and sees Liam Denning crawling all over him. And meanwhile, Barry Barrable hasn't lost any of his racing technique. And look at the concentration. We talked about Denning, but look at Barrable. Acknowledges there he was allowed through. And here comes Dave Maguire, still with an amount of smoke from the rear end of his car. Is that bodywork rubbing off the tyres, or has he got, it could well be oil running on a hot exhaust pipe. Here is your race leader then, coming through, Brian Dade, being followed by Billy Griffin.
And I wouldn't like to be following that car, Maguire, the moment of this oil. And round goes Paul Malone. It's in a very dangerous place. And oh, what an accident. I think that was Quinton Smith who went into the back room. A lot of damage, and hopefully nobody hurt.
Well, certainly no vision for Quinton Smith as he came around there with the amount of smoke on track. He really had nowhere to go. Didn't even see that car of Paul Malloy's and whacked the back end of it.
And that is Michael Leonard Jr. there, edging on his brother to this championship triumph. But he really has to go some now, because right behind him is Liam Denning. Black flag out, that must be for Maguire.
Well, here we are riding with Denning then, down to the first corner, and we see Leonard in front, and Denning just closing on him there in the two tag, and Leonard spins around, and is that Leonard out of the championship? He's stalled in the centre of the track there. This is not a place to be in the middle of a race at Mondello Park, facing the wrong way around and your championship in tatters.
Poor Karl Leonard, watching the world go by and the points go by there. And really, now we saw that racing incident, but it has to be said that Karl Leonard did go wide. Smith's not going anywhere. That was him we saw a second or two ago. And this is the new shaped Fiat Punto. And that's one of the Pratts who are dicing away there with Barry Rabbit.
Well, Clive Pratt hasn't been afraid to come out in the new livery this weekend, and we expect to see all of the cars out on that, the new streamlined front to the Fiat Punto Abarth. But he's under all sorts of pressure now from the deliverance man, Barry Rabbit there, and Rabbit's side rearview mirror there squares in because he's had close contact with somebody, and Michael Leonard is upset about something.
Extremely upset indeed, and he's walking away to find somebody, no doubt to protest, because the Leonard family are considerable disarray again. The championship looks like it's gone. Certainly the race is gone for Quinton Smith, but he still could amazingly get third place in this series.
Well, a highly modified Quinton Smith then makes his way back to the Aidan Fields garage there as Clive Pratt still on track, battling away with Barry Rabbit, and Rabbit not giving him any opportunity at all. And Rabbit closes on him there. Brendan Fitzgerald also getting involved in this scrap.
And this is the battle for sixth place. These three going down the main straight and down into turn one, Honda corner.
Taking a very wide entrance to the corner there is Brendan Fitzgerald. He really is keeping the young charger, Barry Rabbit, tidy. And this time, Rabbit holds it though around the left-hander. As meanwhile, back on board with Karl Leonard as he tries to go around the outside of Alison Lawford. And Alison Lawford there just spun. So not a great day for the Denning Lawford household there, as Alison, who's the wife of Liam Denning, she spun there in front of Karl Leonard, but got through without any damage.
Karl Leonard must be wondering, when can I get rid of this family at the moment? Meanwhile, Barry Rabbit is trying to get rid of Fitzgerald and trying very hard.
Well, Brendan Fitzgerald is not having any of it. He's staying about as close to Barry Rabbit as you possibly can get without getting a formal introduction as they come down, then turn right-handed. Rabbit driving this Punto Abarth as though it were a Mark II Escort. The back end stepping out there as they come down the straight, and he scrubbed off an amount of speed which allowed Brendan Fitzgerald come through.
And up into seventh place, we calculate. Meanwhile, up front, and look at this. This is for the lead. That's Bob Copeland, number 19, trying to get his first win of the season. Bill Griffin has had a win in a Fiat Abarth, but that was at Phoenix Park, which was a non-championship race.
Well, Copeland there showing us that he can do some grass track racing as well, but Bill Griffin, a very, very experienced driver from a long line and a long line of racing family, the Griffins, and Bill, no slouch when it comes to racing or indeed defending, as Bob Copeland is beginning to find out the hard way as they come down the straight then. Bill Griffin taking up a very good position, defensive driver. time down the centre of the road. Copeland tries to run around the outside. Bill Griffin is having none of that, and Griffin gets the best of the run out of the corner to defend that inside line. As he turns left, cocks a wheel, nose to tail then, these two.
Well, it doesn't get much closer than this in Fiat Racing, and it's good clean stuff so far anyway. There's Bill Griffin, ex-Formula Ford, very experienced driver. Bob Copeland, he has been in the supercars and he's also been in the Fiat Uno, so he's pretty experienced too. And he's now married into the Kellett family, so there's a motor racing dynasty.
Well, if you ever needed motivation, you're going to get some there. Meanwhile, that battle goes on between Karl Leonard now and Brendan Fitzgerald. So Fitzgerald, having extricated himself from Barry Rabbit, now finds Karl Leonard crawling all over him. And Leonard makes it round the outside, down at turn three, out at the far end of the circuit. And Brendan Fitzgerald is not recognising his championship aspirations of Karl Leonard, because he battles away back with him. But Leonard eventually makes it stick, comes up into the S's then, up the centre of the road, turning left-handed in.
Where's Fitzgerald? He's got round him. And its confidence must be low at the moment after that terrible mistake there at the first corner a couple of laps ago. It's assisted, it has to be said, a little bit by Liam Denning. But he's perking up. And has he still got an outside chance of this championship? I think his brother certainly thinks so. He's on the sidelines there, egging him on. Meanwhile, back up front. Look at this battle.
Well, a terrific battle here between Bill Griffin and Bob Copeland. Two great protagonists, two great racers, these two. And we're going to enjoy this as they rub alongside one another through that very tight right-hander. And then running door handle to door handle into the left hand. They swing in there. Very, very brave indeed of Bob Copeland to stay around the outside. But very, very clean of Bill Griffin, it has to be said. Didn't take the opportunity to put him off. Copeland there getting up on the grass. And Copeland has got through.
He tried that manoeuvre the last lap and he gets it this lap. Now they come up into Dunlap, braking very late. Oh, a little bit of nudge there from Griffin, but Bob holds onto the car. Front wheel drive, of course. They can sort of drag themselves out of trouble. And look at Joey Freeburn. He's closing on these three.
Well, nothing between these three now as Joey Freeburn decides to come up and play. But Copeland this time takes the opportunity to defend that inside line. And Bill Griffin tries to get a good run on him, leaving his brakes late down into that first corner. Tries to squeeze around the outside, but Bob Copeland can race. But more than Bill Griffin, he can also defend. Watch Joey Freeburn, the Armagh man. He's coming up into contention with these two.
And the new Jenny Copeland will be absolutely over the moon if her husband wins this one. Not too long to go now, but Joey in the third place there, he, remember, is looking for points for third place in the championship. Can he get enough this afternoon? That remains to be seen. Lovely study there of Bill Griffin at work.
Yes, and Bob Copeland, the coppersmith, is going to try and copper fasten the only other win of the series. All the other wins have gone to Liam Denning or to Karl Leonard, and Bob Copeland would be the only other winner if he can hang on to this. But Joey Freeburn has got something in mind.
And there's not many shock absorbers left in that one. They're coming down the main straight. Copeland gets the checkered flag.
Well, Bob, a very popular victory at Mandela Park. How are you feeling?
Good, considering the week, but very good. Brilliant race with Billy. I mean, when you can race like that and come in with it, both people finishing, it's fantastic.
Talk us through that move, Bob. You tried it once, didn't come off, hugely committed the second time.
I had to do it the second time, it's either do or die. There was enough room, like, there was a good credit card, and then Billy left enough, and then I left him a bit on the way out, but enough was done at that stage.
So Bob Copeland becomes only the third Abarth winner of the year, and neither Liam Denning or Karl Leonard are on the podium. But Denning, after all the drama, is champion by 5 points, and Quentin Smith wins the battle for third place in the series. So Liam Denning, the car body repair specialist, a good thing to be when you're Fiat racing, has completed a Fiat full house. In 1997, he took the Fiat Uno Championship, which was then the top Fiat class of its time. A year later, he bought himself a Fiat Punto, or Italian racing saloons as they were grandly known. They had 1400cc engines and Punto bodies, and they are still proving to be a very competitive class even today. Last year, he joined the Abarth Grids. And now, in 2003, he becomes the Fiat Punto Abarth champion. What a trio of trophies to have on your sideboard. But since Michael Cullen's days in various Dunlop Saloon Car Series, has one driver been so dominant on the Tin Top Championship Trail in Ireland? 3 years and three different types of Fiats. Next year, can he make it four?